When you're in Google Analytics, one of the top things people complain about is how frustrating and overwhelming that tool can be. But with a few simple tweaks to the system, you can actually get to the answers that you're looking for surprisingly quick. Today, we're talking about Google Analytics. In this case, how to customize your reports so that you can get to answers that you need. And be sure to stick around to the end of this video because I'm gonna show you a super cool customized report that you're gonna be able to build along with me that'll help you figure out where you're losing valuable traffic. You should probably have Google Analytics open already. So that way you can follow along with what I'm doing in this video step by step. Now we're gonna go into first the source medium report. Now that's the report, it's under acquisitions. We go into all traffic and then we go into source medium. And this report is great because it shows us where all the traffic sources are coming from. We know we got traffic from Google Organic. I know I have traffic coming in from email and which type of email system that we're using. I know I've got affiliate traffic and podcast traffic. So some of these might not be what you have in your own Google Analytics because we use UTMs to actually make sure that information is there. If you need more help on using UTMs, just be sure to check out this video we've created just for you. Once you have UTM parameters already set up, then we actually have the source medium report that builds itself on its own. And this is great, but it's also very general. I know I have a lot of different traffic sources coming in. I know I've got a lot of different results from those traffic sources, but what if I want to answer a specific question like which ones are actually creating leads? I can go to goals. And if I have a goal set, I can find that, which in our case we do. So I can switch this to lead. Now I can see my traffic sources that are actually sending in leads and the number of leads that I'm getting from those traffic sources. But what if I want to know about a specific campaign? So in our case, for our Win courses, we have a campaign called Win and we send traffic that starts with them becoming a lead. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create something called a secondary dimension. And then I'm going to type in campaign because I want to see my campaigns in addition to my source and my mediums. And you'll see very quickly all this stuff pops up. So I have a column that says now campaign and a column that says source medium. So here's the primary dimension. Here's my secondary dimension. And we're getting closer now because I can see that I've got win campaigns here, but I also have all these other campaigns and stuff like that that I really don't want to see. So how do I adjust those? We click on advanced. This is something called a table filter. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna ask it to filter and show me just my win campaign traffic. So you can see here it says include campaign. I'm gonna say campaign containing and win because this is how we UTM our traffic coming in. Now we click on apply and you will now see this report will show me here's the source mediums all for the purposes of the win campaign right now that we have running. And then I can see the number of leads that are generated. So I can see easily the number of leads and which traffic source is really good at bringing in leads for our win campaign. Now this is great because very quickly now I can get to my answer and I know which traffic sources are generating leads from the win campaign. It's really easy to get to that now, but I don't want to have to go through all those steps over and over and over again. So our final pro tip on how to actually customize your own reports is this little save feature here. So when we click on save, instead of just all traffic, I'm going to call this Mercer's Win traffic, and we're going to save that name by just clicking OK. So how do we get back to it for the next time? I click on customization. I click on saved reports and you will see right in the list, there's Mercer's Win traffic report. And this takes us directly to the report with all the changes already in place so that my answers are right there. They're at my fingertips. I don't have to go through and set everything up again. Now let's talk about those answers. I definitely see the types of traffic coming through and the sources of traffic. So I know email traffic and partner traffic and podcast traffic are coming through. Remember, I can see that because I'm using UTMs. Then I can see how much traffic I'm actually getting from those different traffic sources. I can see the engagement of that traffic. And ultimately I can tie it to a result. So I know how many leads are actually coming in from those traffic sources. So what can I do with this? Well, I can see that this particular traffic source has generated a pretty decent amount of leads in a short period of time. And it's got a pretty decent conversion rate compared to the other traffic sources that are coming through. There's only one in fact that has a slightly better conversion rate. And that is traffic that we've gotten from the Social Media Examiner podcast that we recently did. You can see that's converting at 40% here. It helps me understand podcast traffic is a good type of traffic to have. Let's go generate more podcast traffic. So now you know how to customize a source medium report and save that report so you can get right to the answers you need and know where your traffic is coming from. But what happens if you start losing that traffic because you've got broken links? That is the dreaded 404 page. You might not know that's happening, but your users do. And so does Google Analytics with a little customization. So we're going to go into Google Analytics. This time we're going to customize a different type of report. It's in the behavior reports. And it's it's called the All Pages Report. Now, as soon as we get in here, we see every single page that Google Analytics is measuring for us, which is great, but it's not really what we want to know. What we want to know is which of those pages are 404ing. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to flip from page to page title. What this then shows us is all the different titles of the pages instead of those URLs. We're going to look for a certain page title, and to do that, we're going to type in page not found. Now, why are we typing in page not found? You can see in a 404 page, the title of the page normally is page not found. If your 404 page does not say this, it will say something else. You just take that and it'll automatically look and say page not found. So now we can see the different 404 pages. These were all broken links. How do I actually know what the links are? We're going to click into this page title and then we see these links. This is what people actually typed in. They didn't find what they were looking for. They saw a broken link instead. So what do I do with this particular report? Well, first, I don't want to have to rebuild this report later. So if you recall what we did the first time, we come up to where it says save, and instead of a pages report, it is now a 404 report. I click on okay. How do you actually use this report? Well, in our case, we can see people have mistyped a few different things. That's important because we want to make sure that we make them easy to type in. The other thing that we might see sometimes is maybe we sent an email out and the link was wrong. We would instantly see that here. We would see a lot more traffic here and we would be able to go back and fix that. In our case, we started to see people were looking for our tools here. We actually changed what our 404 page actually looks like. And now when it 404 is, it says, oops, looks like you're looking for something. Can we help you find it? Do you want to go to the toolbox or are you trying to look for one of our courses? And that's actually led to leads and sales because we made that change. That change only happened because we created this exact report in Google Analytics and we saw what our users were doing. And you can do the exact same thing. And this particular report that we just customized is one of the many reports in Google Analytics that can help you to grow your business. In fact, we've covered five of my favorites right here in this video, five Google Analytics reports to grow your business. Be sure to check that out. Or if you just want to continue on this journey as we continue to talk about how to measure the customer journey, figure out what's working and what's not, including using tools like Data Studio, just check out this playlist here. Either way, I will see you on the next video.